My approach to building the economy of the future is working because of the strong support of your delegation. And when you see these big projects in your hometown and cranes going up, shovels on the ground, workers with hard hats, I want you to feel the way I feel. Pride.
President Biden telling Americans to take pride in his plan for the economy and making no mention of the ways he's made it worse. Brian Brenberg is a Fox News contributor and associate professor of business and economics at the King's College in Manhattan. Brian, he wants Americans to take pride in the economy.
Yeah,
this
is crazy to me that he's going out on the stump like this and talking about the strength of this economy and taking pride. And, you know, people who aren't there on that stage watching at home are saying, you want me to take pride in the fact that I've got the highest inflation in 40 years and it's still very high and this economy looks like it's tipping into recession? And you're out there telling me to be happy about that? I mean, it's insulting to people. And this economy, you know, is limping along, and now we're talking about a potential rail strike here. So you start to layer these things on top of each other. It just makes no sense the president is out doing this, and I don't think people at home love it.
Well, I'm glad that you brought up the rail strike, because the president has asked Congress to step in to pass some legislation to prevent this strike from taking place. Listen to the president here.
And Congress, I think, has to act to prevent it. It's not an easy call, but I think we have to do it. The economy's at risk.
Mr. President, are you confident you can avoid a rail strike? And what's your message?
That's a big moment. That's a big statement from the president, who's Union Joe. Now, the rail union's calling him a wolf in sheep's clothing, but the reason he wants this rail strike to not take place is because $2 billion could be lost per day, 700,000 jobs. So do you think Congress will be successful in avoiding the strike?
Who knows? I mean, this is the problem, right? You know, the president's confident, but you've got a Congress that's divided. You have key players saying they might not support this. And it would be absolutely devastating to the economy, to the commercial economy, to people who want to travel.
Yeah.
I mean, you've got products that could be sitting on these railway cars that are perishable. You've got chemicals that can't sit on these railway cars. So businesses even now have to start adapting to that. You talk about supply chain problems in this country. They would be exponentially worse if we got this. And the union president is going to give us the worst union chaos we've seen in
decades.
Isn't
that so ironic? And to your point, we spoke to a leader in the trucking industry and a leader in the retail industry earlier in the show, and here's what they had to say about this strike. Watch this.
The fact is, we need each other. Trains have to have trucks. Trucks take to and away practically all they haul. And without trains, well, I mean, you know, trucking is struggling as it is, trying to meet current demand.
The supply chains are always moving, so things are always in transit. Everybody's shopping online, and the parcel carriers are heavy users of the rail. So all of the people who are buying Christmas gifts could see those stalled.
And something that they both said was, and it's something that you've said in the past, is that even the threat of the strike, which is happening right now, impacts the supply chain.
Yeah, if you're a business, you have to look ahead, right?
Yeah.
What's going to happen in the future? They don't know that Congress is going to solve this. Congress doesn't know if it's going to solve it. You talk about trucks picking up the slack here. Again, the Biden economy is an economy where you can't find truck drivers. We don't have enough trucks to pick up the slack. So you see all these pieces. They don't fit together. Then you have the president in Michigan bragging about this economy. People are saying, wait a second, the puzzle doesn't even fit. And you're telling me to be proud of it? President Biden doesn't get that what he talks about in the White House doesn't translate into reality for
people. And that's the thing, Brian, is that when he was in Michigan, he was cozying up to some union workers there, where there's these rail unions that are furious with him across the country. He's really stuck between a rock and a hard place. Do you think that all of this is his fault? Some Republicans are pinning in on him for not being able to get the deal done. Is it more complicated than that? What do you think?
Well, it's always more complicated at one level, but he's the guy who claimed to be the union president.
Yeah.
Okay, when you take that mantle on, I'm sorry, but you have to deal with the blame. And he's got an administration full of people who have zero business business experience. And it's in moments like this where that really shows, to the detriment of America, that they don't understand how an economy works and how it prospers. Again, this isn't an economy to brag about. This is one where everybody's bracing to see which shoe right. drops next.
And Kevin McCarthy said yesterday that he does think that the House has the votes for the bill to pass to stop the strike. But we had Lisa McClain on earlier, and she says, I don't know how I'm going to vote because I haven't seen the legislation yet. Marco Rubio also says he's not going to vote yes. And then, of course, you have all the progressives who are going to vote no as well. So it'll be a very interesting day.
It could be a very close call. And in the meantime, businesses are all waiting with bated breath,
exactly.
and they're very concerned.
Yeah. Brian, thank you for joining us. Waking up
Good
early. We
you.
Appreciate it.
Yep.
I'm Steve Ducey.
I'm Brian Kilmeade.
And I'm Ainsley Earhart. And click here to subscribe to the Fox News YouTube page to catch our hottest interviews and most compelling analysis.